Good morning and welcome to our lower school prize giving. This year, unusually, lower school boys will have been able to see the senior prize giving. Normally, there is not sufficient room in the Great Hall, but virtually, of course, there is room for all. Nevertheless, it's very important that we also have this occasion in our school year where the achievements of lower school boys can be particularly recognised. And so it's a great pleasure to introduce Mrs. Waller, our head of lower school, to introduce the proceedings.
Good morning. I would like to start by welcoming all boys, colleagues and guests to our first virtual lower school prize giving ceremony, where we will celebrate this morning all of the achievements of boys in the lower years at Bolton School in the academic year 2019 to 2020. Even if you do not collect an award today, you will still undoubtedly have had your own personal triumphs this year. And this ceremony is an opportunity for me to say that we, as a school, are very proud of each and every pupil in the lower school. Juggling the demands of a busy academic school, your social lives, family commitments and the varied challenges of modern day life, not to mention the unique and considerable challenges that the recent lockdown has imposed on all of us, none of those things are easy. But you've all managed it, and all of you will have something that you can reflect on this morning, a significant accomplishment over the last 10 months, whether it be academic success, a sporting triumph, or even something as simple as improving your average effort grade. As well as reflecting on your collective efforts, this morning we celebrate the notable achievements of many individual boys across this section in a wide range of areas of school life. I hope that as you hear the names of the award winners read out, you will feel proud and happy for them. As friends and peers, you should celebrate their success because these awards have not been easily won. They will have required hard work, sacrifice, determination and resilience, effort and cooperation, and a willingness to learn. All of these are the important ingredients which go into make happy, successful and fulfilled young men, and characteristics that we look for you to develop as Bolton School pupils. As I did last year, I wanted to take this opportunity to recap on some of the varied successes of this academic year in the lower school. Many of these will have been mentioned in assemblies and celebration lunches before, but as we reflect together as a section this morning, it will do no harm to be reminded of just what an eventful year it has been. Please listen out carefully and see if you can spot something that you have been involved in. I've already mentioned the importance of collective effort and teamwork in the lower school this year, and what better place in school to find that than in our house system? You have the opportunity in your individual houses not just to participate in events on house day, but to collect house points throughout the year by earning commendations. You can also work with boys older than yourselves and put in a collective effort into charitable fundraising and engaging with nationwide initiatives. This year, as well as a wide range of fundraising events, houses have also worked on a number of individual charitable endeavours and have been at the centre of important events like Anti-Bullying Week. This type of work is such an important part of school life, and I would like to congratulate you all for the work that you have done with your houses this year. Again, these achievements would not happen without your hard work and enthusiasm. I hope that your house captain's leadership has inspired you to pursue further goals when you take on those roles and responsibilities yourself further up the school. Every single one of you contributes towards the success of your house, and I hope that you've enjoyed all the activities that you've been a part of this year. Our virtual sports day, of course, is still to come, so there's still a lot to look forward to. Another area of school life that I know many of you enjoy participating in is in sport. Believe it or not, two-thirds of pupils in the lower school have represented Bolton School in sport this year. There have been many wonderful highlights, and even during the recent period of lockdown, it's been fantastic to see so many of you getting involved with the sports department Twitter challenges that have been posted each week. These have included running, cycling, a weekly cricket challenge, to name just a few. As well as your collective efforts in sport, this academic year has also seen continued excellence in a number of individual pursuits, and we are very proud of all our elite athletes in school who show tremendous commitment to their individual sports, often representing school and training with us alongside their own commitments. Alongside sport, there have been many other triumphs this year, particularly in the arts. One notable area of development in recent years in the lower school has been the introduction of the Arts Mark Award, which every Year 7 boy has participated in, developing their own interests in a year-long project. After this morning's prize giving, lower school pupils will have the chance to share in their success in an Arts Award celebration, and I hope that you enjoy this event. Elsewhere, lower school pupils from both divisions have entertained us in many different ways with some spectacular concerts and occasions, including the Christmas Festival and Young Musician Awards. I would like to thank all of those pupils in the lower school who shared their talents with us in the arts this year. Another way in which you've had your voices heard this year has been through our lower school council. And as a result of the hard work of your form reps this year, much has been achieved. Lower school council representatives have met each fortnight and discussed and represented your views on catering, particularly regarding increased provision for healthy choices in the dining hall, fed back on your learning experiences, and excitingly, we'll also look to take work forward with our school's burgeoning eco-society. The council, both in the lower and middle school, continues to grow and develop every year. I hope that you have felt well represented by your form reps this year and will continue to engage with this aspect of school life in the years to come. All of these moments have punctuated the year perfectly, but it would not be right to review the past few months without mentioning your simple, individual, daily efforts to engage with school life. Each week, I've seen the commendation totals rise. I've read many glowing reports which summarise consistent academic commitment and a desire to learn. I also see so many of you show a genuine and real love of learning, just for the sake of it, through your attendance at clubs and societies and through your efforts in lessons and at home. The breadth of interest within this section of the school is remarkable. We have amongst us this morning astrologists, archers, actors and apiarists, climbers and coders, gardeners and geographers, quizzers, scientists, chess players, historians, spelling bee enthusiasts, sportsmen of every kind, just to name but a few. Such rich experiences can only happen in school because you are willing to get involved, and I would like to congratulate you all on your enthusiasm for participation in the daily business of school life and our extracurricular programme. I know that all of you would also wish for me to thank on your behalf this morning all of those people who support you in your involvement in all of the activities that we have reviewed. Firstly, I'd like to thank your academic tutors for the time and effort they've put into helping you to understand their subject. Your teachers take great satisfaction from sharing their knowledge with you about a subject that they love. It really is a privilege to have such committed and interesting pupils. I know that you appreciate their enthusiasm, originality and dedication, and that you show this every day in the hard work that you do. I'm sure that you've also enjoyed the new and unusual aspects of home learning that have taken place over recent weeks, and I'm sure that you will carry on learning from your teacher's wisdom as you progress through school. Alongside your subject tutors, I would also like to thank the hugely dedicated team of form tutors and heads of year in the lower section. No one in school knows you better, and they'll all go the extra mile for you. Behind the scenes, your tutors advocate for you with your teachers and your parents. They give of their time away from their own homes to accompany you to Patterdale, and they have celebrated with you when you have triumphed and been there to pick up the pieces with you when things have gone wrong. They've taken the time to carefully consider how to nurture you as individuals and how to summarise your progress effectively when writing your reports or selecting these morning's awards. I really hope that you'll get the chance to show your appreciation to your tutors this year. It's also very important that you thank those who make succeeding in school possible for you, your family members. Many of you, I hope, will watch this assembly along with you this morning. Your loved ones make great sacrifices to allow you to explore your interests and nurture your talents in school. And I'm sure that even if you don't always show it, you are just as grateful for that support as we, your teachers, are. Please take the time to say thank you this evening for everything that your families have done to you and will continue to do as you progress through school. Last but not least, I must also thank all of you for what you have done in school this year. It has without doubt been an unusual and in some ways challenging year, especially during this lockdown period, when both you and your teachers have had to navigate a brand new working routine. What has impressed me the most is the fact that many of you have done this with so much commitment, diligence and good humour, even despite all the difficulties, still managing to show care, compassion and consideration for your peers, for your family and for yourselves. I know that many of you have felt in recent weeks the pressures of being in lockdown, but you've managed to retain poise and a positive mindset and made some fantastic progress. So thank you to everyone in the lower school for all that you have done this year, and well done.